day.
How'd it go today?
Oh man, it's a dream come true. Everything was good. We competed hard. We got some good shots up. We got some good work. There's really good energy in this gym, and I mean, I'm just proud to be here. Just play hard. They wanted a lot of energy. They wanted our defense to compete. They wanted us to push each other. And like I said, just play hard, man. Just compete.
What do you see yourself bringing to a team, especially like a team like the Sixers?
I bring a lot of energy. I'm a really good locker room guy, really good on court, off the court guy. I'm bringing a defensive demon. I'm a defend at a high level. I'm a rebound at a high level. And one thing about me is every time I touch the floor, I'm going to compete, regardless of if I'm making shots or scoring the ball. I'm going to compete, and I'm going to bring it every day.
When you watch a team like the Sixers during the playoffs, do you think, why compete there?
Of course. To see how up-tempo they play, to see how Ben Simmons brings the ball up, Joel Embiid posts in, and they just play so versatile. They play out of a lot of actions, and I think I could really fit in.
What were some of the things? I know it was brief. What did Elton say to you guys when he met with you?
He was thanking us for coming out, pretty much just saying that he was in our same shoes 20 years ago, to keep the same mentality, just compete every day and be better every day.
Looks like you're a big communicator out there. Is that something that you've developed over the years, or you've kind of always had an act for that?
Well, I mean, growing up, even in school, I was getting in trouble for talking too much, so I figured I could just transform it into something positive and talk to guys out here, communicate at a high level, and I know that's what wins games sometimes, so winning is definitely the most important to me, so something I developed for sure.
How many workouts have you been through so far?
This is my fourth.
So this stage, how are you just feeling? I mean, do you feel like you've developed a rhythm, where are you at with it?
I mean, obviously your first workout, you come in a little nervous. You don't really know what to expect other than what everyone has told you about it the year before or so. And I mean, I was kind of nervous my first one, but over time I started getting a rhythm, started getting a feel for the coaching staffs and GMs and what they're looking for. And I think my first workout, I was really grading myself on whether I was making or missing shots. And once I realized that's not really as big a deal as I was making it, I mean, it just kind of freed everything up for me.
Do you have other schedules, other workout schedules?
Yeah, in June. Actually, I'm going from here to New York. I go to, I got a couple scheduled, actually. So they're coming later, though, in June.
How was it playing for Coach Early?
Oh, man, it was very eventful. That's my guy, man. He's a fierce competitor. He knows how to get the best out of you. And he knows when you're not giving it your all. And he's going to let you know whether that's in a positive or negative manner. I really embrace being around him and just picking his brain, because obviously he's done something that I wanted to do, winning national championships and getting drafted. And he's a basketball mind, and I was able to take a lot of things from him, just learn from him over this year.
You've got a lot of experience in the Pac-12, and how did that help? That's usually an up-tempo type league. Mm-hmm. What was that like?
I mean, every night you're matched up against somebody who's a potential draft pick or a team that's, an elite team. So to play in that system in so many possessions, and every team pretty much gets up and down the floor, I mean, it's prepared me mentally, physically. I kind of know what to expect a little bit. The NBA game's a transition still, but I'm used to playing up-tempo, so it's definitely benefited me.
You're a player with a lot of experience, and a lot of the guys here were today. I know the NBA looks for younger people, but experience, how much do you think that'll help you? You've really played a lot of games.
100%. I think that's, a virtue to me. I think that's definitely a benefit, considering, the NBA, they always draft these young guys, and some of them come in and automatically play and respond, but some of them spend 2-3 years sitting in the G League and developing anyway. So I think the years I spent in college, I've learned every step of the way. I've matured on and off the court. I've gotten better in every aspect of my game, and I think I'm ready to come in and help a team.
Does everyone look at you as a three man?
I mean, it varies from situation to situation. I've been looked at as a 3, 4, 5. I mean, I don't really get too caught up in numbers now, especially considering the NBA is such positionalist basketball. Anybody could be bringing it up or setting a screen or playing some small ball 5. So I'm just the type of person, I just want to be on the floor. Whether that's 5, 6, it doesn't really matter to me.
Thanks.
Thank you guys.